I'd like to welcome you all to this unique event. As it said in the Bruin today, the culmination of a three-week residency. And it's been a very whirlwindy event. Komang Astita arrived January 29th. He is going back home tomorrow. We have been working on entirely new pieces from the bottom up and have been working as hard as we possibly can. And we're very pleased also that we have two members from the Indonesian Consulate General's office here with us tonight, and we hope you enjoy the show. So that's it. There are a lot of notes in the program, so I'm not going to say any more. Read them when you get home. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm Komang Astita from Bali. I would like to say a few words to you. You're very lucky.
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Since we have this lovely evening, I would like to express some words for you that in concerning about the Balinese music. As we know, we have a great group and great gamelan in this campus since it's been a long time. And I have known that the gamelan already brought here by Dr. Hood as a long time ago. And the gamelan was in good shape, and now we can bring them and offer it to you as a new music. Well, Balinese music, I know all of you, maybe some of you already get familiar with that. Music is a very big and very popular in Bali. It's instead of different kind of music. I would like to say here, because in Bali, we have a lot of kind of event which is including music. For example, we have a Hindu religion, and we have a lot of ceremonial thing, which is a human rites ceremonial. And also we have a lot of entertainment. In here, this gamelan is one of the popular gamelan in Bali. This is, we have it part of there. This is, we call it gong kepiar, which is have a metal horns, have 10 tunes, 10 skis in the part. And the gamelan I used to tonight is not based on the one particular ensemble in Bali, but it's a kind of a combination between Balinese gamelan and also Japanese gamelan, and also some instruments, which is like harp, bowl, and so on. In Bali, music is very close relation to the dance. This is Balinese dance. It's always accompanied by music. There is different kind of ensemble can be used for the dance. In this particular gamelan, which is we have a metallophone portion called the bed. This is called gangsa. This is melody, a rolling melody for the gamelan. We have some pattern, which is a form. It's very simple form. For example, we can introduce to you. For example, we have very strong bitter in gamelan Bali, which is kaca. Could you play kaca, please? If we have this, we keep this beat maybe on and on. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, even an 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, second, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we put in gong, 6, 7, gong, 1, 2,
when I'm playing,
4, 5, 6, 7, gong, and we can add that the gong is coming also in the 4th. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. And then I'll keep it that 4, 5. I would like to add here is an instrument called calo, which is play the nuclear melody. This is base of the melody. We have played 5. Thank you. type of music, which is ostinato type, which is a cycle on the eighths or sometimes it's in 16 beats or even longer. We have a lot of big type of song, which is offer, you know, multiplying by 4, 8, and then 16, and then 32, and so on. I would like to hear, to express also here, when we have the Balinese dance, we have a for example here, this dance called Baris, which is a warrior dance. Has also 8 beats in the cycle of the gong. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, gong. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4. Could you play the Baris? Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, gong. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, on that melody. For example, we have a strong, the basic position of Balinese dance, which is on the feet, we call it Tapak Sirang. As you see, my piece is called Tapak Sirang, which is mean the position of the feet is like this. And then we have open it a little bit, and then put the position down, which is the chest is up, and your stomach kick also rising up. And we put the hand like this. Okay. When we have a dance, we have to mention Balinese dance very intricate in movement. This is more the tail. I mean, we have a flicking eyes, for example. We have to count the flicking. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, like that. In other way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then we have also the finger is very detailed. You can see it from long distance, but this Balinese dance usually is intimate, you know. You can feel that the finger trembling. And also we have a kind of position, which is walking, which is on the beats. We call 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. Or even we doubling, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now if we have the baris like this, dong, ding, dong, ding, dong, ding, 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, connection between the music and the dance. Also, tonight I would like to express my great feeling, which is I would like to thank Mrs. Ibu Elaine Barkin, which is invited me to walk for 3 weeks over here. Yeah, that was a very great, pleasant time. And I have a good time over here. And also, I'd like to thank all the musicians over here, my friend, my guru. And also, I would like to thank you all for coming tonight. And I would like to perform for the third piece, which we call it Waton. As the program already said, I came here without any perception. I don't have any music when I came here. And then as soon as I get here, I get this music that I can play. Okay, please, take time. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good night.
Thank you. Yeah.
No, no, no.
Yeah, 600.
It's not electronic.
No.
happens, unfortunately. Although it's probably going to be posted on the net eventually.
Of course, something of this magnitude.
I know. I'm getting requests from all over the world for it. So, my Xeroxing bill would be a fortune. So I'm going to have to figure out some way to load it up onto an FTP site or something. I can't deal with
it. Maybe you could venture on satellite.
Yeah, no, there's a bus. Set up my own internet now.
So, what are you going to do now?
I don't know.
What are you going to do now?
I haven't the faintest idea. I'm going to take a long vacation for one thing.
So, you think you got it?
You should have been here for the thing that was a dance, dance pieces, an amazing, illusion, because the camera didn't actually have to go all that far to do what it did, but it was just so cleverly thought out, the set was built the right way, there was one in a recent movie, I think it was one of the ones with DeMorne, the one which is with this TV lawyer or something. They're in a building with a big open stairwell, atrium kind of thing, and it goes from literally like from her office out into an upper balcony in the elevator, down and out. And I really had to admire it. Oh, and that's the other thing, the actors have to learn the lines.
Yeah, right. Yeah, I actually memorized something.
Because there's no going back.
Well, I suppose that's enough.